After changing the face of rock and roll as we knew it, Jim, way back in the early 60s, with a little bit of help from their chums, the Fabs, the Rolling Stones have sneaked back into the studio to work on what would probably be their 293rd album. Now, on a beach special next year, we'll be saluting their services beyond the call and duty to sex, drugs and rock and roll. Now, as Jump Back, their compilation album testifies at the moment, there aren't many bands who come near them as far as singles are concerned. So here they are, the Beat, we salute them, those dinosaurs of rock and roll.
When they were originally mastered, they were, most of these tracks were mastered for LP versions. So the original versions are masters made for LPs, for analog LPs, which are totally different from what you would make if you were making CDs, which is a lot what a lot of people buy, or cassettes even. And most people buy either in those two things. I mean, I think this is available in some places on LP. So the whole point of the way it was originally mastered is kind of lost. People have these very purist ideas and they want to hear something that was once they bought or they heard.
They did a lot of searching about old tape rooms and boxes and stuff, trying to, you know, I know a lot of research went into it, and they found some interesting, you know, the originals, a lot of them, and it, you know, for me, it's interesting to hear the stuff coming back, you know, and, you know, well, you mixed it that way then, and now, you know, you got a second chance to play with it, you know, it's that interesting, you know. There's some good songs on there, not bad. Some of them. You know.
I think it's a very interesting compilation. There's some surprises on there, like Wild Horses and things, which I think is good to mix with, you know, stuff through the years like Miss You and Waiting on a Friend and even up to Rockin' a Hard Place. It sounds quite an interesting theory to have all these songs put together.
Obviously the songwriting thing has changed from the beginning, when we just used to write the first thing that comes into your head and so on. But I think that both in the earlier and later songs, there's all different ways of writing songs. I mean, you can sit down and write a real a song that just starts and two people are just sitting there playing it, and it's a real kind of both people contributing to lyrics and melody and arrangements and so on. Or you can just bring a song completely finished into it, which there's on this compilation, there's a lot of that.
The idea of writing songs hadn't occurred to us until our first album came out, and then, well, you know, really, that was the best of your material that you play, you know, and we're going to need some new stuff. Now, either you go out and look for songwriters and look for songs, or how much simpler, as Andrew Autumn said, if we could write our own.
For a while, we wrote kind of Beatles kind of songs, and then we wrote ballads, and we found it very hard to write rock songs. And it took a while to get that. We were still doing cover versions, and eventually we graduated to writing rock songs.
the Wonder Horse had Rebel the Alsatian. Roddy McDowell had Lassie. John Noakes, well, of course, he had Shep. Meet our dog, the Beat Dog. This is Fang. Half Rottweiler, half Grizzly Bear. You enjoy the music, aren't you? Of course you are. Now, the rap group, most likely to. Gunshot, that's what the NME said about them. A hardcore rap crew from Walthamstow.